Hello and a very good evening. You're watching the news at 6 on Rajya Sabha television with me, Frank Pereira. Here are the headlines. Winter session of Parliament to be held from December 15 to January 5th. Three bills to be taken up in the upcoming session to replace ordinances. BJP and the Congress step up campaigning in Gujarat. Prime Minister Narendra Modi to address rallies on November 27th. Congress Vice President Rahul Gandhi addresses public meetings in Porbandar and Ahmedabad. Thirteen coaches of the Vasco da Gama Patna Express derail in Chitrakoot district of Uttar Pradesh. Three people killed and nine others injured. Railway Minister announces compensation for the families of the victims. And in cricket, India score 11 runs for the loss of one wicket after dismissing the Sri Lankan team for 205 runs on the opening day of the second test in Nagpur. Well, dates for the much-awaited winter session were declared on Friday. The Cabinet Committee on Parliamentary Affairs recommended that the session will be held from December 15 to January 5th. Here are the details.
The winter session of the Parliament will begin on December 15th and conclude on January 5th. The dates were recommended by the Cabinet Committee on Parliamentary Affairs in a meeting headed by Home Minister Rajnath Singh on Friday morning. According to procedure, the recommendation of the CCPA would be forwarded to the President.
The Cabinet Committee has proposed that we will have the winter session from 15th December to 5th of January of the Parliament.
Justifying the government's decision to call the winter session after the Assembly polls, Parliamentary Affairs Minister Anant Kumar said this isn't unprecedented and that previous governments, including the Congresses, have done it in the past. He also urged opposition parties to cooperate and allow the House to function smoothly.
I request all the opposition parties and all the political parties to participate and make the Parliament session fruitful and meaningful, because this winter session many important bills are being considered and many important issues of national importance and issues relating to the people are being debated.
The Parliamentary Affairs Minister also listed some important bills that are likely to be taken up in the upcoming session. One would be a bill to end triple talaq and the bill to grant constitutional status to the National Commission for Backward Classes. Three bills will be taken up in the upcoming session to replace ordinances. These are the Goods and Services Tax Compensation to States 2017, the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code Amendment Ordinance 2017, and the Indian Forest Amendment Ordinance 2017. Congress has, however, made it clear that they will continue to corner the government over issues like GST and demonetization.
Har samasya GST ka hai, aur demonetization ka, aur GDP ka hai. और दूसरे जो भी चीजें जम्मू एंड कश्मीर में क्या हो रहा है और ये जो टेररिस्ट का मामला है पाकिस्तान ने जो सैयद हाफिज को ये किया है वैसे यानी जो राष्ट्रीय अंतर्राष्ट्रीय समस्या को भी उठाएंगे.
The winter session will have 14 working days with December 25th and 26th being declared Christmas holidays. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Meanwhile, campaigning is in full swing for elections in poll-bound Gujarat. Congress Vice President Rahul Gandhi on Friday addressed various rallies in Porbandar and Ahmedabad. Prime Minister Narendra Modi is also slated to address 8 rallies in Saurashtra and South Gujarat during his visit to the state next week.
With just a fortnight for the first phase of polling in Gujarat, election fever is at its peak. Both BJP and Congress stalwarts are busy addressing rallies in the state. Prime Minister Narendra Modi too will reach his home state on November 27th to address election rallies in Saurashtra and South Gujarat. In Ahmedabad on Friday, Defence Minister Nirmala Sitharaman said The Congress party has not played the role of a responsible opposition.
Democracy mein sarkar mein baithe hue party ke upar agar prashn poochte hain uska jawab dene ka zimmedari jitna hai utna bhi utna hi opposition mein jo party hai aur isse pehle center mein sarkar mein the uske upar agar prashn poocha jata uska jawab dene ka zimmedari bhi wo opposition ko bilkul hai. ये नहीं है कि वो ऑपोजिशन गुजरात में है और अभी केंद्र में ऑपोजिशन में है प्रश्न पूछना उनका ड्यूटी है मगर जवाब देना उनका ड्यूटी नहीं है
कांग्रेस वाइस प्रेसिडेंट राहुल गांधी इज आल्सो ऑन अ टू डे विजिट टू द पोल बाउंड स्टेट व्हाइल एड्रेसिंग रैलीज इन पोरबंदर एंड अहमदाबाद राहुल सेड इफ कांग्रेस विंस द इलेक्शंस इन द स्टेट द गवर्नमेंट्स डोर विल बी ओपन टू द पीपल The Congress leader also met the fishermen community and promised to create a separate ministry for fisheries if the party comes to power.
जो काम किसान करता है, वो काम मछुआरा करता है। और आपने मुझे कहा था कि अगर एग्रीकल्चर की मिनिस्ट्री हो सकती है, तो मछुआरों की फिशरीज की मिनिस्ट्री क्यों नहीं हो सकती है? और ये बिल्कुल सही बात है। फिशरीज की मछुआरों के लिए एक अलग मिनिस्ट्री होनी चाहिए आपकी जो मांगे हैं आपकी जो कठिनाइयां हैं उसके लिए एक अलग मिनिस्ट्री होनी चाहिए और कांग्रेस पार्टी की सरकार दिल्ली में आएगी तो यह हम काम करके आपको दिखाएंगे
Meanwhile, the BJP has released its fifth list of 13 candidates for the second phase of assembly polls in the state, dropping two sitting MLAs. Polling for the two-phase elections for the 182 assembly seats will take place on December 9th and 14th. The results will be declared on December 18th. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha Television.
Well, 13 coaches of the Vasco da Gama Patna Express derailed in Chitrakoot district of Uttar Pradesh on Friday morning. Three people were killed and nine injured. A medical train and an accident relief train were sent to the accident spot for rescue operations. Railway Minister Piyush Goyal announced ex gratia compensation of 5 lakh rupees each to the kin of the dead and 1 lakh rupees for those with grievous injuries. Railway Ministry has ordered an inquiry by the Commissioner of Railway Safety. Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath expressed grief over the deaths of the passengers in the train derailment.
कारण का पूरा ज्ञान तो जब रेलवे के अधिकारी आ जाएंगे तभी ज्ञात हो पाएगा क्योंकि टेक्निकल कारण प्रतीत होता है लेकिन एज अ प्रिकॉशनरी मेजर हमने एटीएस की टीम को भी रवाना कर दिया है ताकि किसी प्रकार का अगर वो है कोई और बात है तो उसको जाकर देख लिए लेकिन प्रथम दृष्टया जो बात आई है पहले वहां कुछ रेलवे के अधिकारी और हमारे जीआरपी के लोगों ने बताया था कि संभवतः ट्रैक फ्रैक्चर होने की वजह से हो सकता है हादसा
Moving on, now global ratings agency Standard & Poor's has maintained its sovereign rating on India constant at BBB while keeping its outlook for the country stable. The move dashed hopes of domestic stock market investors who pushed BSE barometer Sensex for a seventh consecutive trading session on a ratings upgrade hope. Standard & Poor's has said sizable fiscal deficit and high government debt detracts from sovereign credit profile, adding that fiscal gap is in line with expectations. The agency, though, expects the Indian economy to grow robustly over 2018 to 2020. It said it has favorable view of the reforms that the Indian government has undertaken, lauding the country's fiscal consolidation drive. The rating comes in contrast with Moody's decision that upgraded India's credit rating to Baa2 from Baa3. But in other news now, Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu has said that unity and integrity are India's strengths. He said this during his meeting with the representatives of the National Foundation of Communal Harmony in Delhi. The Vice President also met children who were participating in the Communal Harmony Week. He asked the children to take care of the country's cultural heritage and help India become a global center for learning. The Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu also released a book written by former Secretary General of the Rajya Sabha, Vivek Kumar Agnihotri. The book, Daring Democracy, is Agnihotri's autobiography, where he talks about his social and professional experiences.
एक तो ये है हमारी एक तरह से कह लीजिए ऑटोबायोग्राफी, लेकिन जैसी ऑटोबायोग्राफी जनरली आपको पढ़ने में आती है उससे थोड़ा ही हटकर है। इसमें सिर्फ कुछ रेलेवेंट एक्सपीरियंसेस जो कि स्टूडेंट हो चाहे टीचर हो चाहे कोई और हो उसको वो समझ में आए और उससे वो कुछ काम निकाल सके।
Well, the Delhi High Court has dismissed a plea against Bollywood epic drama Padmavati. The petition filed by Akhand Rashtrawadi Party sought a committee be set up before the film's release to check whether there is any distortion of history. Calling the petition hopeless and misconceived, the court ruled that such petitions were encouraging those agitating against the movie. The court also directed the petitioner to approach the censor board as the court was not inclined to entertain its plea. Recently, the Supreme Court had rejected a plea seeking a stay on the release of the film, saying the censor board was yet to certify the movie. Meanwhile, protests against the film Padmavati took a violent turn as a man's body was found hanging at Nahargarh Fort near Jaipur today, while with threatening messages referring to the film scribbled on the nearby stones. Reports say that the police has identified the dead man as a local jeweller. An investigation is still on. Well, here's a quick look at what else is making news across the country in our segment Nationwide. The Supreme Court today granted 6 weeks' time to Gujarat government for apprising it on whether any disciplinary action has been initiated against the policeman convicted in the 2002 Bilkis Banu gang rape case. The bench ordered that the matter is listed for hearing in January. However, the court sent a separate plea seeking enhancement of compensation to be awarded to Bilkis Banu would be taken up next week for a hearing. The Supreme Court today dismissed a petition seeking cancellation of an election if the votes of Nota were higher than the candidates. The petition was being filed by BJP leader Ashwini Upadhyay, who sought for cancellation of the candidature and the particular election process if the votes of Nota were higher than the candidate. A three-judge bench of the Apex Court refused to entertain Upadhyay's plea and dismissed it. The by-election to the RK Nagar Assembly constituency, which fell vacant after the death of Tamil Nadu Chief Minister J. Jayalalitha last year, will be held on December 21st. As per the Election Commission announcement, the votes will be counted on December 24th and the election process will be completed before the 26th. Time for a short break now, but news and updates will continue on the other side. Stay tuned, we'll be right back.
Prolific British poet and story writer Joseph Rudyard Kipling, one of the first masters of short stories in English. In 1894 appeared his Jungle Book, which became a children's classic all over the world. Kim, the story of Kimball O'Hara and his adventures in the Himalayas, is perhaps his most felicitous work published. Set in and concerned with India he had come to know and love so well. In 1907, Kipling became the first English language writer to receive the Nobel Prize for Literature.
I'm Dr. Ravi Mehrotra. I direct the National Institute of Cancer Prevention of ICMR, which is located at Noida. I'm going to talk about how more than 60% of all cancers occurring in our country are preventable. Please keep watching Eureka.
Pachikari सफेद संगमरमर पर रंगीन पत्थरों की जादूगरी, लातिनी भाषा में कहें तो पीटरा ड्यूरा। ताजमहल, सिकंदरा, एतमादुद्दौला और आगरा के लाल किले में है अद्भुत नमूने। ईरान और एशिया से आए कारीगरों का हुनर जिसे अपनाया भारतीय कारीगरों ने और दिए एक से बढ़कर एक ऐतिहासिक स्थल।
The story we thought we knew. The story of magnificence. The story of bloody battles. Of those who ruled and those who left their footprints. The story charting the course of our past. Talking History on Rajya Sabha TV.
Welcome back. You're watching Rajya Sabha Television. Well, on a four-day visit to India, Sri Lankan Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe today called on President Ramnath Kovind at Rashtrapati Bhavan. After meeting Wickremesinghe, the President said that relations between India and Sri Lanka are unique, warm and friendly. He further added that development cooperation forms an important part of bilateral engagement. The President also said that India is keen to strengthen the economic pillar of its relationship with Sri Lanka. Later, the Sri Lankan Prime Minister also met External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj. Both sides discussed steps to further intensify close and mutually beneficial relationships between the two countries. Well, just a day after his release, Mumbai attack mastermind Hafiz Saeed started his anti-India rhetoric. He has said that he would gather people across Pakistan for the cause of Kashmir. India has come down heavily on Saeed and Pakistan, saying these comments are nothing but re-articulation of the agenda of terrorists who have thrived across the border. The Home Ministry asserted that Jammu and Kashmir is and will always remain an integral part of India, adding that such action will get appropriate response on the ground.
भारत का दृष्टिकोण आतंकवाद को लेकर के या पाकिस्तान की उसकी अंदर भूमिका को लेकर के अब विश्व के वो देश भी स्वीकार करने लगे हैं जिन्हें पहले इसे स्वीकार करने में कोई हिचकिचाहट थी, और इसलिए यदि पाकिस्तान डिनायल मोड में है या इस तरह से चल रहा है तो एक बात हम समझ लें कि बहुत देर तक पाकिस्तान की ये रणनीति सफल नहीं होने वाली।
Well, after days of political turmoil, Zimbabwe got its new president on Friday. Emmerson Mnangagwa was sworn in as the president at a grand ceremony held in the National Sports Stadium in Harare. Thousands of supporters thronged the stadium cheering the new president, who is also referred to as the crocodile. A number of dignitaries and foreign diplomats were also in attendance. Opposition leaders also attended the event. Soon after taking oath, Mnangagwa addressed the packed stadium, pledging to serve all Zimbabweans. He said he was deeply humbled to take the role of the president. He also paid tribute to his predecessor, Robert Mugabe, calling him a father, mentor, comrade in arms and his leader. Mnangagwa's swearing in follows the dramatic departure of Robert Mugabe after 37 years of authoritarian rule. It was the sacking of Mnangagwa, Mugabe's vice president, that prompted the military to take control. Mnangagwa had fled the country after being sacked but returned to a hero's welcome on Wednesday.
Malaba, Chief Justice
Well, here are some updates from across the world in Global Buzz. A suicide bomber rammed his motorcycle into a vehicle, killing a senior Pakistani police officer in Peshawar. Additional Inspector General Ashraf Noor and his gunmen were killed, while six cops escorting the vehicle were injured. Noor was on immediate, there was no immediate claim of the responsibility. Papua New Guinea police today cleared the remaining asylum seekers from an Australian-funded refugee detention center, allegedly after beating several refugees. Many of them were severely injured and needed medical treatment. The United Nations Refugee Agency denounced the use of force and called for protection of the refugees. The U.S. Navy called off its search for three American sailors missing since their plane crashed in the Philippine Sea. The C-2A Greyhound transport aircraft with 11 people was traveling to the USS Ronald Reagan aircraft carrier when it crashed. Eight sailors were rescued shortly after the incident. Well, moving on to some sports news now. India were 11-1 after wrapping the Sri Lankan team on 205 runs at the stumps on the opening day of the second test in Nagpur. Lahiru Gamage bowled Lokesh Rahul for 7 runs, while Murali Vijay and Cheteshwar Pujara both were batting on 2 with India trailing by 194 runs. In bowling, off-spinner Ravichandran Ashwin took 4 wickets, while Ishant Sharma and Ravindra Jadeja took 3 apiece. Sri Lankan skipper Dinesh Chandimal with 57 runs and Dimuth Karunaratne with 51 runs were amongst the top scorers for the Lankan side. Well, here are some updates now from the world of sports in Sports Beat. Indian batswoman Harmanpreet Kaur extended her contract with the Women's Big Bash League side Sydney Thunder for 2 years. Harmanpreet signed the contract last season, which made her the first Indian cricketer, male or female, to play in Australia's T20 tournament. South Africa's Supreme Court increased Paralympic athlete Oscar Pistorius's jail sentence to 13 years and 5 months after the state argued that his original sentence of 6 years was lenient. Pistorius was imprisoned in July last year after being found guilty on appeal of murdering his girlfriend Reeva Steenkamp. Her family has welcomed the decision and said the court showed justice. FIFA President Gianni Infantino said that he wants to bring new rules for the transfer system by next year. He said that there is a need of more transparency in the transfer process to ensure more credibility. He added that he wants to focus on the regulations around players, agent and size of the squads. Arsenal secured the top spot in the Europa League Group H despite a 0-1 defeat against Cologne. Cologne made a good start and almost opened the scoring in the initial 5 minutes of the game as John Cordoba kicked a cross shot which Arsenal keeper David Ospina pushed away. Both teams took chances to score goals but failed till the second half. But a penalty earned Cologne their first goal after Shrugurase converted it into a goal in the 63rd minute. This was Cologne's second win in 17 Bundesliga and Europa League games this season. Well, that's it on this newscast. Do stay tuned for the big picture coming up on the other side of this short break.